Good. Hey, Metabolics is a bioscience company, and we're focused on clean solutions for plastics, chemicals, and energy. Our first product that we're commercializing this year is a biodegradable, bio-based plastic. The kind of things that our technology is aimed to solve include energy security, litter, and global warming, CO2. And I'll get into the problem first, and then the solution. Show of hands, how many people in the room subscribe to the peak oil theory and that we should plan for a world without oil? Almost everyone, very good. What about plastics? Almost all plastics today are made from oil. You don't have oil, try living a day without plastic. What are you going to do? Okay, 540 billion pounds a year of plastic made. The vast majority ends up in landfills. The biggest dumping ground, the ocean. There's an island of plastic on the Pacific Ocean about the size of Texas. Our plastic naturally biodegrades in the ocean. Of the 540 billion pounds of plastic made, each pound generates between 2 and 4 pounds of CO2 during the production process from petroleum. Our first technology is greenhouse gas neutral, and we're going to drive that to be greenhouse gas negative going forward. Metabolics is a leader in the world of industrial biotechnology. And what that means is we take a variety of renewable resources, and through a series of processes, including genetic modification, fermentation, we can deal with the industries of plastics, chemicals, and fuels in a variety of days and ways, and our technology allows us to access each of these markets. Moving to what we do, here's our plant that's being constructed with our joint venture partner, Archer Daniels Midland, in Clinton, Iowa, and we will be commercializing this family of products this year, and it's starting up as we speak right now. So this technology is live and it's meaningful. Now, as mentioned, it's biodegradable. This is a picture of a credit card type piece of plastic. Within 90 days, it'll naturally biodegrade anywhere microbes are present. A plastic bag, biodegraded in 20 days in a lake in Wisconsin. We can tailor the rate of biodegradability based on the application. It allows us access to huge markets. We have 3,000 potential customers we're looking at, both for conventional applications like printers and cosmetic cases, but very innovative cases. Ag film that biodegrades in the field. Shoreline restoration where the plastic can hold plants in place and naturally biodegrade as the shoreline recovers. It also offers a whole series of options for plastics end of life. Right now, landfill is the predominant, a little bit of recycling. But with a material like ours, we can accelerate composting, anaerobic digestion for the production of biogas, and even better, a product that's biodegradable by design, like the ag mulch film example. The same core technology allows us to access chemicals. We can deal with bio-based chemicals and produce bio-based chemicals we're working towards that go into solvents, coatings, paints, and a number of things, all built off our same technology and our same platform. And this is next in our sights in terms of what we're commercializing. Our third platform really illustrates how fast this technology is moving. We can express the same plastic directly in the leaf tissue of crops. We've already expressed near 4% in switchgrass and near 4% in sugarcane. What this means is a negative carbon footprint and extremely low cost of production that allows us to compete with petroleum plastics at very low oil prices. It also enables the creation of the vision for many of us, the biorefinery, where out of one refinery we can make fuels, chemicals, and plastics in a very environmentally advantageous way. It's been a very long road for Metabolics. This technology was found in 1992. A lot of bumps along the way, a lot of things we've had to overcome, but we're positioned wonderfully now. We have a great joint venture partner, Archer Daniels Midland, and we actually can see huge opportunity. The issue for us is how do we actually get this to market more quickly? Now, the way I see that happening is the integration between consumer and societal demand for this type of product, the industry, both with the established infrastructure and what we're doing as entrepreneurs, and government policy. And I think each of these are moving forward, but I don't believe they're moving fast enough, and we have to try to integrate them in an effective way. So just to conclude, you know, this technology is here that can address all of these major issues. We're doing it now, and it can make a huge difference for us as we look towards the future as it relates to energy security, as it relates to CO2, and as it relates to litter. That's it. Thanks.